So is the economy finding regime shifts using bank level data? Okay, and I know, Hamilton, you had raised this question. And it would be really nice if we can get bank level data. Again, all of this is aggregated, and I know there are sensitivity issues and all of that, but because, you know, the level of the reserve is a signal of what's, of anything, right? It has information, so. This will require a lot of work, I think, to just assemble, put together the data. And, you know, we raised this point earlier about the granular, getting down to the micro level earlier with the foreign exchange market. How can we get the quantities and the, you know, that are being traded at the micro level, okay, by institutions, so we can form some judgments. Yes.
Yeah, on this one, I think one of the surprising things is that we do so little research on bank behavior. I question whether there is such a thing as a liquidity preference. I think that that's another one of the ancient myths that we have inherited, which doesn't, I mean, I can't see any, you know, if you say, you know, what sort of actual behavior that represents a preference for liquidity. I think that, you know, we should be talking about treasury management.
Okay.
And, you know, this is what actually happens. So that, you know, there is a notion of how you manage finance in the light, in terms of returns, maturities, and so on, and currencies, in the light of the way in which you are expecting to employ it. But it isn't, you know, there isn't a preference for something called liquidity. You know, there's a whole continuum of instruments which, you know, people choose between. And, you know, the notion that, again, that continuum goes beyond financial assets to real assets, which underlies a lot of the transmission mechanism. So you're saying that your preference for liquidity affects whether you do actually invest or you buy real property and things like that. I mean, I think all of that really, really, you know, requires some, sort of. We have to look at our basic assumptions. So I would actually rephrase that as a research, question. To say that we really have to ask, we really need to develop a research program in terms of bank behavior.
Okay, develop a research program explaining bank behavior. Yeah, it will be broader than the liquidity preference issue.
And maybe you could also distinguish between two broader regimes that might determine this, apart from, you know, the intrinsic business model for a bank itself, where I think a lot of the regulatory framework will come to play, because the regulator will put certain weights and risks associated with various instruments. So banks may take that into account, as the regulatory regime shifts. So that could be one angle at.
So regulation will also play a role in the behavior.
I think so, and there is you know international shifts, and they're being replicated at the national levels. So you would still need to see, find evidence at the national level of how this is might be influencing the liquidity preference.
Yeah.
And then one angle would also be to see if there is maybe a structural shift somewhere independent of this, but given the crisis notion of what happens to liquidity in an economy. And I'm not sure to what extent our economies are really, burdened with that, but that would really be an issue that has been looked at in the advanced economies, how they have been affected by the crisis in terms of the liquidity in the banking system. But I think if we think we have been more isolated, we could still take the other track of bank liquidity as a business model and how regulation, for instance, influences that, and what for the banks is shifting really in their profitability decision making, I think.
Yeah, those are important points that I am actually going to consider making a note.